It's great to be here in Canada. You know, I really mean that. You know, for the first time in our history, though, as a nation, we don't have to emigrate. We don't have to come to Canada. We want to come, don't get me wrong, but we don't actually have to. And by the way, thanks for having us over the last two centuries. It was very nice of you. But for the first time in the history of my country, we are a nation of immigrants. We don't know how to handle it. And people are saying about how racist we've become. And I disagree. We've always been racist, given half a chance. You know, it's just for years we had to practice on gypsies and people from neighboring countries and, you know, students. Oh, they're much paler than we are. Come on, let's kill them. You know, this kind of thing. I was in a taxi in Dublin recently, and the driver, he actually blamed the immigrants for the traffic congestion on the streets of Dublin. And I'm going, how can it be their fault? He's going, of course it's their fault. Doesn't everyone slow down to stare at them? What? And the biggest source of immigration in Ireland at the moment is from Poland. A sizable percentage of the Irish population is now Polish. And the best thing about Polish immigration to Ireland is that I finally managed to fill up the XYZ section of my address book. Yeah. That was a little gap there for years. I don't have to pretend I've friends called Dr. Zorro or Madam X anymore, which is good. I had to wait 15 years to do that joke, ladies and gentlemen. Every day I prayed for an influx of Polish people to my country. I've got this great joke about Eskimos, which I hope to do in another 15 years' time if global warming continues the way we hope and expect. Anyway, we'll see about that when the time comes. But I'm all over the place at the moment. My confidence is in absolute tatters. I've been playing Connect Four with my children, that excellent game of strategy, and I was letting them win, thinking that this would help their confidence in life. But no, they just became very objectionable. Saying, oh, Daddy, you lost again. You're just a big loser. Daddy is a loser. And I was thinking to myself, if they think their father is such a completely useless tosser, this could affect their confidence in a negative way in the future. So I started winning again at the Connect Four. And it felt pretty good. But then they became very patronizing, saying, oh, Daddy, you won again. Well done, aren't you a great daddy? And then I realized those little feckers are letting me win.
What?
Didn't do my confidence any good at all. We're all so busy nowadays, we've no time for anything. For couples who live busy lives, by the way, I think the most important part of the day is that first half an hour after you hop into bed in the evening, isn't it? This is the vital time. This is the chance to catch up on the day's events and discuss your hopes and your dreams and blame each other for things that went wrong earlier on. But it also happens to be the time of the day that my wife decides to text every single person she knows. For hours and hours. In fact, the only way I can get her attention in the bed is by text. You know, would you ever move over there? You've got the whole duvet. And then I get a text back. Who is this?